I have reached my breaking point of having to do this life thing alone. I just want to be held, nurtured, loved, cared for, physically, emotionally, spiritually, mentally, in all aspects. I want my heart and soul to be seen and held. I just can't do it alone anymore, and I'm at my breaking point.
Is your man treating you like shit? Just throw them away.
We interrupt this program to prescribe you with 1,000 milligrams of red vitamins.
Right here, right here, right now, right now. It's the right time, right time, right time. It's the right sound, right now, right now, right now, right now, right now. Right now. Till the whole pie down, pie down, pie down.
What's good, Shadow Realm? It's your boy Reclaim Your Throne coming at you with another crazy video. But first, my goal is to get to 10,000 subscribers by the end of the month. So make sure you go ahead and like, comment, share, subscribe. And you already know, Reclaim Your Throne.
Boy, you think you're cool because you have a leather jacket? Is your man treating you like shit? Just throw him away.
So, you heard it. If your man is treating you like crap, throw him away. Well, here's the thing. For one, reverse the roles. If I, okay, as a man, were acting as if I'm beating up, say, hey, this mannequin right here in the corner of my screen, and it's a woman, I mean, the repercussions online are crazy. Yet, you have this woman who is acting like she's beating some man up, which, those dummies, they're actually pretty fun to play with. But it's ridiculous, right? It's absolutely ridiculous. She has all this anger, all this bent up aggression. She really has a hatred for men, yet online she is not censored. She's glorified and praised, and her followers go up. Why? Because misandry is okay in this current day and age when it comes to society, all right? Where women can openly say they hate men, openly display violence towards men. They can even, you know, do something to a man in real life, and they're not going to get punished as much as men are, sadly, all right? But knowing this, understanding this, you have to understand that if you run across a woman like this, bro, you need to be able to recognize a sign. What are the signs, okay? Well, first of all, her face, it just looks kind of funny. All right, two, the tattoos, obviously. Three, the just, okay, as you see, she's farting on the guy. She's, you know, if she doesn't have good manners, right? If she burps out loud or farts out loud or anything like that, bro, do not wife her, bro. I'm telling you, she's mad masculine, dog. So these are things that you need to look out for, okay? And women who advocate for women to do these things, right? The not shaving their armpits, you know, not shaving a coochie, all that stuff, bro. And I know a lot of people go, oh, well, you, if you're a man, you're going to lick the fur. No, bro. No, bro, okay? We already have established that we are not eating any box, all right? We're not eating any WAP. From here now on, okay, it's just not going to happen. We do not subscribe to that narrative that men have to eat box. Therefore, we don't, all right? And we won't now. I mean, if you like doing it, it is what it is. It increases your chances of cancer. The studies are out, all right? The fluids are not good to ingest and digest. So, I mean, you can do what you want with it. But at the end of the day, it's not safe. It's not good for you, all right? But these signs that a lot of these women display, it'll be personality signs, right? She's cursing crazy in public. Okay, she's not acting ladylike. You know, she acts masculine. The tattoos, obviously. And then her face, she just kind of got that face, like a bulldog kind of face. And there's just a lot of things. She's pulling out wedgies in public where, like, she's not trying to hide it. Now, if she, you know, is trying to hide it, then that's cool. But if she's just like, oh, I got a wedgie, and, like, announces it and then pulls it out, bro, no, sir, bro. Do not cuff her, all right? I'm telling you right now, I'm saving you the time. It is what it is, because she will turn into this after a while, spitting on her hand, like, dude, right? It's just, these women are not feminine anymore, okay? And and obviously, we have a higher masculinity rate in the community, but it doesn't matter what race they are, all right? They could be as white as her, as pale as her, and they're still not feminine.
I have reached my breaking point of having to do this life thing alone. I just want to be held, nurtured, loved, cared for, physically, emotionally, spiritually, mentally, in all aspects. I want my heart and soul to be seen and held. I just can't do it alone anymore, and I'm at my breaking point. I can do it physically alone. I've been doing it, but I don't want to. I don't deserve to, because I am worthy of companionship, of community, of love, of affection, of support, of someone lifting me up, motivating me, encouraging me. I am worthy of that. So I deserve to receive that. I don't want to do it alone anymore, and I've been crying all day because of it.
Wow. So that was a pretty upfront and focused admission on the part of this woman. And honestly, I genuinely don't see how she is single. She is pretty much gorgeous. All right. I know a lot of guys, oh, she's a five. She's very attractive. And most of y'all would love to be with her. Now, here's the thing. This is why I think she's single. All right. She probably drank the feminist Kool-Aid. She was doing it out on her own and da-da-da-da, I'm all independent, stuff like that. She was sticking her nose up at men who pretty much were on her same level in life, all right? Now, as far as attractiveness, yes, she could attract a pretty attractive guy, right? She could have many men if she wanted, but here's the reality. She needs to lower her standards, maybe her physical attractiveness standards, all right? Maybe you have to go for that medium ugly guy in the face, but he's got a nice body, okay? Maybe you have to go for that guy who is, you know, handsome in the face, but he doesn't have the greatest body. Because a lot of women, they are not willing to concede on certain things, and we know this trend of having or getting the ick has started. So women will rule men out because this thing gave them the ick, or that thing gave them the ick. They're looking for things to rule the man out on instead of looking for things to qualify him on, and that is one of the biggest issues that they have. Now, as far as this sister, I don't know, but I'm going to jump off on a limb, don't sue me, but I'm going to assume that she is looking for a black man, all right? Now, where are you going to find these high-class black men who are also looking for commitment? Well, this is what I'll tell you. A lot of those guys are not going to be in shape. They're not going to be 6'5". Those types of guys, they're going to be, you know, Kevin Samuels like to call them, Henrys, I like to call them Malcolms, okay? They're going to be those Malcolms, those mildly attractive, lucrative, communicative, operational, likable men. So these guys, they may not be in the best shape. They may not be super hot to you, but they're going to make a good partner, okay? For example, you know, I'm not trying to bring up other YouTubers, but Dr. Boyce Watkins, why? Right? I mean, he ended up not getting what he truly could have gotten with his status in life. But here's the thing. He got what he felt like he wanted, all right? And he's the type of guy who is in the position financially that these women want, but he doesn't have the aesthetics. Now, I know he's losing weight and whatnot, so that's good. But he still doesn't fit the height category, especially when it comes to black women, especially light-skinned women. They're pretty much the most picky. Honestly, like, out of any woman, it's gonna be the light-skinned woman who's gonna be the most picky when it comes to looks, because she's very, I mean, I'm not saying that this woman is conceited or this woman is superficial, but I'm saying light-skinned people tend to be more picky when it comes, not light-skinned men, but light-skinned women for sure, bro. Just from my anecdotal experience, I don't have no damn studies. Oh, you're just making things. Bruh, I'm outside. We're touching grass. We live life. So what I'm saying is they are going to be the most picky. So maybe she's going to have to come down on that height standard. Maybe she's going to have to come down on that finance standard. Maybe she's going to have to come down on the physical attractiveness standard. Maybe you need to get a guy who it looks good to you, but maybe he's not financially stable, or maybe he's not as intelligent. There's something that you're gonna have to give here that I'm pretty sure she's not giving, because there's literally no way that this woman doesn't have millions, but thousands of suitors, thousands, day after day after day, DM after DM after DM, guys in her DMs. So she's rejecting a lot of guys, and she's talking about being alone. But then when, you know, a guy applies pressure, and then he's about to set that date, he's about to set that, you know, that time period. If a guy does that, then it's like, oh, I got work in school, I'm busy. Don't lie, like, y'all are not giving the work in school excuse, especially women this age. I don't for a second believe, and this might be a skit even, this might be an attention grab, I don't for a second believe that this woman doesn't have DMs flooded galore. Maybe her Instagram is trash. Who knows? Maybe she got like the 2013 Instagram picture quality. I don't know. But there, I mean, it's just like, it just doesn't make sense. So there's something that she is doing wrong. And she's not really technically alone. I guarantee she is getting her back blown out by a Pookie, most likely, or a Ray Ray, or a Thug Max Alpha Simp, as I like to call it. She's getting her back blown out by Thug Max Alpha Simp. There's no way that she has not been intercoursally active within the last 6 months. So there's a lot of issues compounding. You're perpetually single. You're still having intercourse. You're increasing your body count. And now you're on the back end, which, I mean, she looks very young. She looks very attractive. But she could be on the back end when it comes to her fertility, okay, age-wise. So, you know, there's so many different factors that go into this, but let's keep it a buck. Maybe you need to start looking outside of your race, right? Okay, here, that's another thing. Maybe it's not gonna be a black man. And we're not mad at that, right? Maybe you need to start letting those white guys' DMs get through, okay? Stop leaving the white guys in the requested, all right? Stop leaving the Hispanic men in the requested, okay? Get outside, think outside the box, get outside of your comfort zone, because the reality is, a woman like this, there's literally no way that her DMs are not flooded. And she's on TikTok, and I'm gonna assume she looked like this. She got at least 20,000 TikTok followers, and I'm probably lowballing it. She might even be TikTok famous. I ain't never heard of the bitch. But the reality is, she is single, and there's a reason why. All right, and I think it's because her standards are through the roof, and she's talking about, oh, being alone. But in reality, this is just another field for attention. So anyways, you already know what it is, man. It's your boy Reclaim Your Throne. Make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe. Send your relationship request to email down below, or screenshot of your Cash App, so I know you're being on ties, man. Y'all already be on your mark freaking need with the BS. You already know. Reclaim Your Throne.
Want to become an elite level athlete? Well, look no further. The Reclaim Your Throne Elite D1 training course is all you need to take your performance from subpar to the creme de la creme of athletes all around the world. The purpose of this course is to give you a comprehensive weight training, speed, flexibility, recovery, and endurance program that is meant to prepare young athletes for collegiate and professional sports. This course is packed with over 2 hours of creative, action-packed lifts narrated and coached by yours truly to assure increased strength, speed, flexibility, recovery, and endurance. Hey, I get it. Training alone can be tough and can even make you feel misguided or somewhat unmotivated. But with this course, I walk you step by step through each and every lift to make sure you're using the proper form to prevent injuries and that you're hitting the correct muscle groups to render maximum results. So what are you waiting for? It's now or never. So go ahead and get the training course today so you too can reclaim your throne.